tonight's matchup between the Duke Blue Devils and the Virginia Tech Hokies. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
Mr. Nessler, I like the two big men at the power forward position. Two of the more highly skilled players on the court. Definitely a matchup we want to pay attention to.
And now for the tip. And with the tip, we're underway here in the first half. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Off the mark. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
The Blue Devils move into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key in the zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Sinks the shot. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
I tell you, Brad, he's a complete player. It's great to watch someone with such versatility out there.
Territory. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there. Up and inside.
With the jumper. Missed the jumper. Robinson handles the pass. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. He makes the block. Robinson is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
Things aren't coming easy for him right now. He's in a rut.
He launches a three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And the ball is saved. Great job. Bad decision there by the freshman. On the right side.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
The Hokies are on the run. Entry pass in the paint. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Takes the jumper, busts the J. The Hokies set up into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the deep corner and come up short. Tucker handles the feed.
Spacing.
Tries for two. He buries it. They work the perimeter. They move it into the front court. The small forward handles the pass. Tucker picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You can never have enough leadership on your roster. If you're a coach who's lucky enough to have a couple of upperclassmen, you're definitely at an advantage.
Second. The Blue Devils now running a zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
On the right side, gave it up. Number one with the foul, second team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
Hey, underclassmen are an important part of any program. With a year under his belt, the coaching staff expects solid play from him. Nothing but nylon, NBA.
The Blue Devils here running their zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
On the outside, launches the three. They got it. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
What's great about him is the ability to pass and score. It's a
blocks the shot. Loose ball kept in. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, a two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
In the lane. Missed it. He fouled him. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He is going to the line. Misses. Second shot is good. Zone offense now. Cross court. Looks at a three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
They try to really get balanced in that they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high percentage shots.
Tickles a twine.
That basketball.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion. On the outside. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how to dribble use the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
From way outside. Jumper won't go. Robinson handles the pass. They're working around the perimeter. From the corner. Nope. Working it around the perimeter.
Double team now, bad angle.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
for two. Off the glass and no good. The point guard takes the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important than how talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. Bella commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
The Blue Devils will step to the line for the first time. He misses the first shot. Gets the second. That trap could spell some trouble. Pushes it up. Up for two. The shot's off target. For the bucket, goes. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Around the arc. He tries the three.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. We're at the 8-minute mark. Out on the wing. He shoots from downtown. And score it. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Tries for two. Off the mark. Pushes it up. Goes up with it. Can't connect. Throws it up for two. Loose ball save. And, of course, here, Dick, are the conference standings.
This is when you want to excel. Conference play is what it's all about, Brad.
White makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
We're at the 7-minute mark. Moving it around the perimeter.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Got it in the low block. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip, going one way, and you spin back the other way.
Working around the perimeter. Shoots from outside. Missed the jumper. Nice pass to the low block. Gets it to go. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. The Hokies are cranking things up at the defensive end, and they're going to extend that pressure.
An aggressive move on their part, Brad. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
Now with 10 to shoot. It to beat the clock. The missed shot. The Hokies running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Hamilton handles the pass. Trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. Great shot. 5 minutes left in the game clock. The Hokies look like they want to use their defense to speed up this game.
You know, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the horses. Otherwise, it doesn't make much sense to play full court defense, Brad.
We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Inside. The Blue Devils now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Outlaw handles the feed for the bucket.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
This guy's really known as more of a power guy.
He has all the tools to play down low. He can put a lot of pressure on the defense.
Too physical. Number 14 gets his first sweat of the night.
Hey, it's important that this kid gets into the offensive action right away, Brad. He's going to make an instant impact.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. It in. He pulls up with a jumper. Bust the J. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Guys, if you haven't noticed, the coaches want the ball being pushed up the court. The tempo doesn't seem to be at a speed which is conducive to their style of play. Let's see how the players on the court react and make changes moving forward.
Our trusty sideline reporter, Erin Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Missed it. Pushes it up. Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Well, we'll see if they've decided to go in another direction with things right here, Dick.
It wouldn't kill them to get a little diversity in their play right now.
Number 24 is called for the foul. Third team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets the first shot. Second one, no good. The Hokies running their zone offense here, Dick.
Well, the key in the zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Pushes it up. He shoots from the corner. Nails the jumper. Looking for a good shot. He shoots the jumper. They got it. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I love the four-round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Looking for a good shot. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Buries it. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump with ease. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
It's good. The Hokies now running a zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
On the dribble, gives it up, tries for two. That was nice.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion. Trying to go inside.
Puts up the jumper. Knocked it down. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you get the points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Nails a sweet jumper. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He takes the three. Off the mark. Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Off the mark with that shot. He hammers it home. Two off the glass and no good. At the half, the Blue Devils are up by one. Virginia Tech has turned the ball over a lot more than normal in that first half.
They're very sloppy in moving the ball tonight, and as a result, turnovers are piling up like dirty laundry.
When we get going here today, these will be some of the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Cross-court. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory like a sixth man. Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
To shoot. With the big shot. Nope. Robinson handles the feed. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Number 15 handles the pass. Goes up for two. And we'll head back down to the other end. He buries the shot.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
On the right side. Puts up the J. Can't connect. Allen handles the pass.
They all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude Dunkaroo.
Number 21 gets the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. The missed shot. There they come with a double team to stop it. The man can't escape.
What a great defensive trap there.
Down in the low block. Puts it up. Perfectly executed. Who will win the battle of tempos here tonight? That's what we want to know right now, Dick.
Well, Brad, controlling the tempo can be very difficult, especially for the entire game. But if you stick with your strengths and make changes when needed, winning becomes a lot easier.
There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
Well, he spotted an opening and he just absolutely great first step and he exploded to the goal.
Buries it home. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Let's take another look at this dunk.
Hey, when you can finish above the rim, you've got nothing to worry about, my friend. You should always throw it down, and you have the chance.
Number 15 comes up with it. The Hokies in transition. And a slam. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Jumper scorches the net with a J. The Hokies now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots. Up and inside.
Unloads. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Around the perimeter. From left of the circle. And he missed. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with a shot. Scores it. Takes the pass in the paint. You betcha. Good cut, great pass right there.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see. High step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Baryshnikov in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Gave it up. He goes up with it. He buries the jumper. There's a double team waiting there. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He throws it up from downtown.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports. Experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
Great trap initiated by the defense. And we'll get a change of possession. The Blue Devils have been making it happen with a number of different players, Dick.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel and vibe.
They work it around the perimeter from the corner.
Excellent jump shot right there. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Harm and foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Robinson goes to the line for the first time. First shot is good. And he got them both. The Blue Devils are going into their zone motion offense now. Pass on the post, turnaround jumper, missed it.
There's the trap.
And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. For two. He makes the shot. They go into the low block. He attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. Sets a screen for his teammate.
Look at that spacing. The defense is denying any opportunity to get a shot off on those screens, Brad.
He shoots from the deep corner. Missed the jumper. Walker receives the ball. trying to feed inside. Foul charge. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
At the free throw line. Opportunity. Second shot is no good. They work the perimeter. With the J. Jumper won't go. Number 15 gets the ball. Trying to pack it inside.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
The small forward takes the pass, takes the jumper, can't connect. Allen receives the ball. 8 minutes left in the game clock. The point guard takes the feed. On the outside, had to go up high with a shot, bust the jumper. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. On the outside. Goes up.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Nice low post play. Good entry to the box.
Off the glass and no good. Perimeter. Puts up the shot. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Working it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Off the glass and no good. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. And a momentary look from three-point land. Six minutes left on the game clock. He wants a three. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Nope. With the jumper. And score it. Gave it up. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Inside. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. My goodness, Dick, have you ever seen such poor shooting before?
I'd say horrific, awful, terrible, poor, appalling. I'm absolutely embarrassed, Brad.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
They'll work it around the arc. He tries the three ball, nails the jumper. And now getting set up here in a four around one.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when the team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
We're at the 4 minute mark. Now with 10 to shoot. The big shot tickles the twine from downtown. Tries for two. He misses it.
Hey, as a coach, you really like to see your kids get up and challenge shots like that.
A lot of times, a challenge is enough to make the offensive player change their shot in the air. Fires away. Nails a sweet jumper. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Kicks it out. Ten to shoot. For two. He's money with the shot. Here's a double team. The Blue Devils move into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Knocks it down. About 2 minutes remaining. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they play with four people on the exterior.
On the left side. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up. Missed it. Looking for a good shot. He puts up the J. Knocked it down. About a minute remaining for the bucket. He missed. They get an open three. Off the mark. on the run. On the dribble, gives it up. They get out on the break. From the corner, perfectly executed. Shot clock is dead. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
The Blue Devils now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Virginia Tech is on the receiving end of a blowout.
No surprises here. They were fighting an uphill battle from the start.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.